Under the cover of the Second World War, the Nazis instigated a reign of terror over the millions of prisoners who found themselves within the barbed wire fences of the concentration camps. The true horror and barbarism that occurred in camps such as Auschwitz, Bergen-Belsen and Dachau was truly horrendous. Following the end of World War II, a number of trials took place to bring the perpetrators of the Holocaust to justice, and these sought to bring some sort of punishment for the evil that had occurred. The most high-profile trials were the Nuremberg trials, in which many remaining members of Hitler's Nazi government, such as Hermann Göring, Rudolf Hess, and Ernst Kaltenbrunner, were brought in front of a judge. However, other trials did take place, to bring specifically the evil staff of the concentration camps to face up to their crimes, and one of these was the Ravensbruck trials. These took place to bring those guards and camp officials from Ravensbruck, a predominantly female camp, to court to face up to what they'd done. In total, 38 defendants were tried in 7 trials, and 21 of these were women. Today we look at one evil woman who was sentenced to death for her despicable role in the Holocaust, and in particular for the barbarism that she inflicted upon prisoners at Ravensbruck. So join us today as we look at the justified execution of Vera Salvequart, the evil nurse of Ravensbruck, and remember to support our channel, please make sure to subscribe. Born on the 26th of November 1919 in Czechoslovakia, little is known about Vera Salvequart's early life. She was brought up by Czech and German parents, and after completing a period of schooling, she began to train as a nurse, having moved to Leipzig in Germany. At this time, Hitler had seized control of the country and was instilling his dictatorship and Nazi regime onto the country. It was this and his requirement to expand his Reich or empire that signalled in the Second World War as he invaded Poland, France and large landmasses within Europe. One thing that isn't commonly addressed though is the state of Germany before the war broke out. As Hitler seized control, he instilled a number of rather severe rules and regulations onto the population, and many of these centred around race and aimed to persecute and isolate many of the minorities within Germany, including the Jews. The Nuremberg laws were passed in 1935, which came around as the Nazis wanted to instill their ideas about race into law. They championed the Aryan race as a superior German race and claimed that Jews threatened the German people. These laws outlined how someone was classed as Jewish, and in the years that followed, more restrictions and rules were passed to isolate and segregate Jews. One of these rules in particular sent Vera Salvequart into a concentration camp herself. In 1941, she failed to reveal to the Gestapo the identity of her Jewish boyfriend, and this was seen as a rather serious offence, and for this she was sent to Flossenbürg concentration camp for 10 months. This was a rather serious crime within Nazi Germany, but her time in prison did not teach her much, as within a few months of her securing her freedom, she was arrested yet again for having another relationship with a Jewish man, and was then sentenced to another 2 years in prison. So despite being around the age of 23, Vera had found herself in prison twice. However, things would get worse for her. On the 6th of December 1944, whilst in prison, she helped 5 officers who had been held captive escape, and following this, more severe punishment was inflicted upon her. Because of this, she was sent to Ravensbruck concentration camp as a prisoner. Ravensbruck was seen during the Holocaust as one of the main female camps, and it was found north of Berlin. It's been estimated that around 132,000 women passed through the camp. Around 50,000 of these were from Poland, which made up the majority of the prisoners. Around 80% of the prisoners were political ones, and many were forced to undergo hard labour and work as slaves. The death rate inside Ravensbruck was rather high, with around 50,000 people dying inside the camp's walls, either from execution, starvation, disease, or some form of experimentation. The conditions at the camp were rather terrible, however Vera Salvequart found herself inside the camp herself as a prisoner. So how could her execution be justified? Well, at the time there was a shortage of SS personnel inside of the camps, as many were forced to leave their post to go and fight and try and repel the advancing Allies and the Red Army. We're talking about 1944, when the tide of the war was severely turning against the Germans. And because of this, the Germans were sometimes forced to use specifically German prisoners to work inside of the camps, supervising other inmates. As Vera Salvequart had previously trained as a nurse before the conflict, she was chosen to serve in the camp's medical wing as a nurse during her stay at Ravensbruck. During her day working in the camp's infirmary, she would regularly oversee the gassings of thousands of sick and ill women. Her role inside the camp was truly horrific. She was first required to fill out the death certificates for the dead, who had either perished inside of the camp's gas chambers, or who had died inside the hospital wings of disease. Then she would inspect the corpses for either gold teeth, which were then ripped out and melted down to help finance a German war effort. It seems that as time went on, Vera seemed to enjoy her sick work, and then she seemed to take a more proactive role in the execution and killing of inmates. To save the hassle of transporting prisoners who were due to be murdered in the gas chambers, simply for saving time and manpower, Vera Salvequart often took matters into her own hands. She regularly poisoned prisoners to simply avoid the effort of taking them to the gas chambers, and she was known to have murdered a number of prisoners inside of the camp in this way. Former prisoners at her trial told of her murderous ways, and she was said to have administered a poison powder to around 50 of the prisoners, with a dozen of them dying. At trial, a witness would describe how Salvequart used to administer the poison to prisoners. She said how she used to tell the inmates that they were going to be sent on a transport and that they needed to take the powder to gain strength. If they refused, they were then given a lethal injection by Salvequart, and then these women would fall into a deep sleep and then stop breathing. It was said that at one time she would often do this to 5 different prisoners. So the woman who was initially a prisoner inside of Ravensbruck very quickly turned into an evil member of staff who inflicted much suffering onto others. She stated, "I remember that the sick had no trust in the beginning because they thought I took part in the mass murdering. I must say that in their place I would have had the same impression. I was locked up without interruption, couldn't go anywhere alone, and all they knew about me was that I lived where they'd murdered so many people. Additionally, the prisoners saw when I entered the washroom, and they heard the women scream and therefore assumed I was part of the mass murder." So she claimed she was a prisoner inside of the camp, which technically was true, and she did have her freedom restricted, but she chose to take her work further and to contribute to the final solution. She also claimed to have acted in a pleasant manner towards prisoners, and claimed that she allegedly helped to save some children's lives by swapping their ID numbers out with an already dead inmate. She claimed to have hidden one child and fed him, and because of this she was threatened with being sent to the gas chambers. Then apparently some prisoners disguised her as a male prisoner, and she kept this up until the end of the war, however this is disputed. Ravensbruck was liberated in April 1945, and with this she was captured and then turned over to a military tribunal in the Ravensbruck trials. At trial she stated that a former lover of hers was a British spy, and she said that she had stolen plans for the V2 rocket and handed them over to the British through her spy boyfriend. Because of this, she asked for clemency, however this was denied. It was clear she was a member of staff at the concentration camps, despite also being a prisoner who took her work seriously and went out of her way to murder innocent people, thus contributing to the final solution, and for this she was sentenced to death. On the 26th of June 1947, she was taken from her cell in Hamelin prison into the execution chamber. There to carry out her execution was Albert Pierpoint, who had previously met with Vera Salvequart to calculate her height, weight and the drop required to snap her neck. On the day of her execution, there were 13 prisoners to be hanged that day, and she was the very first. Inside the execution cell, a double gallows had been created to hang prisoners simultaneously, and at around 9 a.m, Vera was led into the chamber flanked by guards. Her identity was confirmed, and then she was ushered up the stairs of the gallows, where she met Pierpoint again, as he placed a black hood over her head. Pierpoint then fastened the noose around her neck, and within minutes of her entering the chamber, the trapdoor was released, and Vera Salvequart plunged to her death at 9:03 a.m. The story of Vera Salvequart is a rather interesting one. A lady who was previously a nurse then found herself imprisoned inside a concentration camp and then eventually became a murderer inside of Ravensbruck. It was clear she helped to kill a number of prisoners and even administered the poison herself, and for this it's easy to see why the courts found her guilty. Once again, thanks for watching. To support our channel, please make sure to subscribe, and once again, thank you so much for watching.